Hello everyone, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share my step-by-step process for getting my everyday curls. This is basically what I do every time I wash my hair and I'm planning on wearing my hair down, whether I'm going out that night or I just want it freshly washed and styled for some kind of special occasion. It's also how I will technically prep my hair for a half up tutorial, or I will sleep on it and then the next day I will film, say, an updo hairstyle. So this is something that is requested. I hope you guys enjoy the tutorial and learn a little bit from my process. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos, and let's get started. So the first step in this whole process is always washing and conditioning my hair. I wash my hair about once a week, and I can usually wear my hair down for about 3 to 4 days without needing to recurl it. One of my goals for 2021 is to strengthen my hair so it'll grow even longer. I recently actually cut off 4 inches, so I want to grow that length back, but I want to make sure it's healthier than it was before. Let's support each other. So if you have any hair goals that you are planning for 2021, make sure to leave them down below in the comment section. Depending on your hair type, you're going to want to use a certain type of shampoo and conditioner. This can be tricky to figure out, so I've been using Function of Beauty. A big thank you to them for sponsoring today's video. You may have already heard of them, but it's basically a unique formula of shampoo and conditioner for your specific hair type. They have a quick hair quiz to find out details about your hair, so you can receive customized products that work specifically for you. Since I knew what I wanted for my hair, it was easy to complete. I just selected 3 things that describe my hair type. So I chose wavy and fine for my hair and then normal for my scalp. And since I color my hair, I tend to have dry hair. So for my 5 hair goals, I chose deep condition, hydrate, color protection, nourish roots, and then soothe scalp. I also chose purple as my bottle color since this is my favorite color. And for my fragrance, I chose eucalyptus and mint. I also added a hair serum since I always use one of these after I wash my hair. Then when I received my package in the mail, they came with convenient pump tops. So I just popped those on and they were ready to go. So another thing that's very important to me about shampoo and conditioner is that it's vegan and cruelty free. So if you guys want to give it a try, I will leave a link in the description down below. You can get 20% off your very first order. So once I've washed and conditioned my hair, I like to gently pat dry my hair and then apply the hair serum. Then once I'm out of the shower, I like to let my hair air dry while I apply my makeup. It can be really beneficial to your hair to cut down on heat tools. And even though I rarely blow dry my hair, this helps cut down on the time that I'm actually using my blow dryer. So when my makeup is done and I'm ready to finish my hair, I'll just grab my blow dryer to finish drying it the rest of the way. I usually start by parting my hair and then aim the nozzle at my part just for a few seconds to kind of help set that in place. And then I'll just finger comb my hair while I dry the top of my head just to ensure that the hair will fall the right way once it's all dried. Then to help add some significant volume to my hair, I'll flip my head upside down and completely dry it the rest of the way. I think this is my biggest tip for getting volume. It's something I get asked all of the time. This method will dry your hair going upwards. So once it's all dry and you flip your head back right side up, the hair will naturally kind of fluff up, giving it a lot of extra volume. So once my hair is dried all of the way, I like to spray it with a heat protectant and then brush through my hair to help smooth it out and just kind of distribute the product. Then I'll part my hair on the side and split my hair down the back of my head and then bring all of my hair forward over my shoulders. This just makes it easier to see all of it so I know what I'm curling. So then I'm going to grab my curling iron, and I actually like to use 2 curling irons, a 1 inch and a 1 1/4 inch. I know that probably sounds like a lot of work, but you always set the curling iron down in between each section. So you just pick up a different one basically each time you go to curl a section. So starting at the top of the back of my head, I'm going to take a 1 inch section of hair and clamp the curling iron near the root. Then I'm going to twist it twice around the section and wait for the hair to warm up. Then I'm going to drop out the top and then twist the iron a couple more times around the rest of the section, making sure to leave out about 1 inch at the bottom. I don't curl all the way to the bottom. I leave that a little bit straighter.
So once the hair is warm, then I'll drop it down out of the curling iron and toss it over my shoulder just to get it out of the way. Then I'm going to divide off a new 1-inch section of hair, and I'm going to do the same process as before, clamping the section near the root, twisting the iron around the hair, and then just waiting until it warms up. Then I'm going to drop out the top part and continue wrapping the section of hair around the iron, working my way down to the ends. And sometimes I'll even just slide the curling iron down the end to make sure that it's a little bit straighter than the rest of the section. And with each section, I am also going to alternate between the 1-inch curling iron and the 1 1/4-inch curling iron. I also never use them at full heat. They're usually set around 340 to 360 degrees. That's just the best setting for my specific hair color and type. And then with the hair right around my face, I like to make sure the bend lines up with my chin. Just the sections that are right at my face. I just find this to be the most flattering. I know some people, they like the bend to hit right at their cheekbone. So just try it both ways and see which one works better for you. So once I've curled all of my hair on the left side, I'm just going to switch and do the same process to all the hair on the right side. And another thing is that I'm also curling all of my hair away from my face. This is my favorite way to curl my hair, because I think it's the most flattering on me. And I also find that by using two different sized curling irons, it also helps keep the curls from sticking together too much. So once I've curled all of my hair, I like to grab a hand mirror and check the back of my head to make sure there aren't any pieces that I missed. And if there are any that look like they're a little bit more flat than the others, then I'll just grab my curling iron and curl them again. I also prefer to finger comb my hair after I've curled it instead of brushing it out with a brush. I just find that this will help separate the curls without my hair going all frizzy. After that, I like to use a strong hold hairspray to help set my curls. And as I spray it, I like to kind of pull the hair up at the crown of my head just to kind of create a little bit of extra volume. And then I will spray underneath my hair while separating the hair out with my opposite hand. And then lastly, I like to spray a little bit on my fingers and just smooth that over my part line. This will just help lay down any hair that is sticking up, little flyaways, and kind of smooth down the hair around my face.
That wraps up today's video. Let me know in the comments section what your specific hair goals are for 2021. I plan on just keeping it as healthy and strong as I can so it will just continue to grow along. Make sure to like and subscribe. Click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos. A big thank you to Function of Beauty for sponsoring today's video, and I will see you next time.